Violent crime surging not just in major cities, but even in suburbs, especially Georgia. In Cobb County, police believe golf pro Gene Siller was shot dead on the course because he may have witnessed a crime. This comes after a jogger was shot twice in one of the Atlanta's richest neighborhoods last month. And now residents of that town are looking to break free from Atlanta. We've been covering this for a while. Here to discuss it, Georgia native Jeremy Hunt. Jeremy, first off, why do you think all of a sudden the crime in Atlanta is going up and it's bleeding out into the suburbs?
Well, I mean, there's a crisis of failed leadership, Brian. I mean, if you look at the city of Atlanta, the leadership there, this is not just some random COVID crime wave, as the mayor likes to say. This is what happens when you fail to support the people, the men and women who defend the city, the police officers who keep the city safe. This is what happens when morale gets low because they don't trust that the mayor will defend them. And this is what happens. I mean, it's a crisis. I can't tell you how serious this issue is. I mean, look at the murder rate is up 40% in the city. There have been 368 shootings just this year, Brian, in the city of Atlanta. I mean, so this is, it's so real, and a lot of people are very afraid, obviously, and so they're doing right. whatever they can to try to come up with creative solutions to defend their communities.
And, you know, if you're not safe at a golf course, where are you actually safe? So look at some of these stats. Murders are up 33%. Incidents are up 56% overall. Rape up 86%. Robbery 17%. No help is coming from the federal government because they're on the fence between critical race theory and this whole criminal justice reform that says don't go to prison, no cash bail. You are not for what Buckhead's doing. Buckhead says, hey, you can't handle my security. I'm not giving my tax dollars and putting into a sinkhole. We want our sovereignty. Let Buckhead have their own police force. You are not for this movement. Why?
Yeah, well, I'll say it's better that the city can stay together and we can come up with solutions that benefit the entire city. I mean, this issue is not just exclusive to Buckhead. It's all the neighborhoods around the city. And so I would love to see the city come together and come up with creative solutions so that everyone can benefit from this. But let's be clear. I think it's a good thing that Buckhead is at least putting pressure on the city to do something about this.
Jeremy, you've heard that mayor speak. Jeremy, you've heard the mayor speak. She's basically blaming the cops for everything.
Oh, yeah. I mean, that's kind of the Democrat talking point right now is that, you know, if anything goes wrong, blame the people who are out in the street actually trying to make it right. make things better. I mean, I don't understand the logic there. And I think that's why she's not running for re-election is because she realizes that the failed leadership has resulted in actual and real victims being terrorized by the crime in the city. And so, I mean, I just ask everyone to pray for the city, pray that people would start to value their lives and stop shooting each other. And they would understand that their lives have intrinsic value and to actually put a stop to this crime epidemic that's taking over right now.
All right, now, if there were more people like you who have risen through Atlanta to go into the military, and now you're going to getting your degree from an Ivy League education and then able to speak about this, is if there was more people like you, we wouldn't have this problem. But I actually thoroughly back the people of Buckhead, and I think other communities have to take charge of their own security if the cities won't. They are helpless to do it, and they're tired of getting shot while jogging. Jeremy, thanks so much for joining us.
Thank you.